Welcome to our channel Coding Solutions. In this video, I am going to continue the topic exception handling. In my previous video, I already said about how to catch an error, how many errors are there, and how to solve those exception handling. In this video, I am going to continue that. Just see, I have written a program to save some time. You all are familiar with this code because I have already discussed in my previous video. So now I will show you that you can write the errors in a one line. Suppose you can write value error, comma, zero division error. That I will show you. Now let me cut this. You all know what is the output of this. Now what I can do is that I have written here except, okay? Except. Now I will use a method sign. In parameter, I will write here value error, comma, zero division error. Okay. Value error, comma, zero division error. In a one liner, I have done it. Now just print, you have entered incorrect. You have entered incorrect input. Okay, that's it, done. Print, you have entered incorrect input. Okay, done. Oh, sorry, I made a mistake here. I was founding, where is the mistake? Sorry, I found it. I have written a print. It should be print. Okay, now let's print. Enter first number. First number, let me give your 9.5, because I have taken an integer value, integer input, so I am taking a float. Okay, and second number is suppose 2. Okay, see, you have entered incorrect input. See, this is it. See, I have given 9.5, it is showing that you have entered incorrect input. Okay, now let me give here 0. Enter second number, let me give you a 10. Okay, let me reverse it. First number, let me give 10, and second number, let me give 0. See, you have entered incorrect input, because 0 cannot be divided. Now let me give you another thing. Suppose in first number I give 9.5. okay, suppose in first number I give 9.5. Let me give a float value and check. I have taken an integer input. Let me give a float value. See, when I am entering the first value as 9.5, it is just saying that I have entered incorrect input. Now suppose I give you a 2 and let me give you a 9.5. See, you have entered incorrect input. And finally is printing, because I already said the finally will be always printed. See, finally I have written thanks, so finally is printing. That's it, done. Okay, now let me show you another thing, how to use a race keyword. So let me delete this program. Race keyword, RAISE. Let me show you that. Raise keyword. Raise keyword. Okay, now let me show you. Def, I'm just making this. I'm doing a vote. Okay, vote. Age should be there. You all know that age. Put age. Then I write if if age less than 18, then raise what? Raise value error. Error as invalid voter, because he will not be able to vote now. After 18 only he will be able to vote. Invalid voter. Okay. Invalid voter. Done. Now return, if I write here, you are allowed to vote. You are allowed to vote. Okay, done. Now I have to call. Now let me print. First of all, let me give vote. What should I give here? Vote, suppose I give a 19. Okay, I give you a 19. Again, let me print and give there some below edge. Vote. Let me give a 16. Okay. Now let's see what's the output. See, there is an error. See, error is coming. Can notice why the error is coming? See, error is there. Now to solve that error, I can use here try. See, I will show you. You also know that I will show here one thing. See, if I write here try, let me copy this. If I write here try, and just do this, and let me give you a 17. Vote, let me write here 17. Okay. Done. I guess 17. I made a bracket mistake here. 17. Done. Now it's done. Okay. Now here I should use except. Value error. Here I'm making a value error. I have done raise value error, so I should write here except value error as E. You can take anything. I am taking E, a short form, so that I can print it easily. Suppose I can write here print E. Okay. Now let's see what's the output. See, it's showing absolutely right, invalid voter. First is none, then it's invalid voter. Are you getting my point, right? By using the try and except, I'm printing it correctly, invalid voter. Suppose you give your, now suppose I give your 27. Suppose I give you a 27. Okay. Suppose let me change this value also. 28. None. Okay. See, it's printing none. Okay. Now you are getting my point. So I think you have understood what is a race keyword. And by this we complete the exception handling. And this is also our end of basics. From next day onwards, we will going to start object-oriented programming, OOP. Okay. So if you have any doubt, just watch my previous videos or raise a comment. I will obviously help you. Thank you for watching this video. I'm not the one who's always right.